In the early months of 1912, William Howard Taft was the American president. Titanic, under construction, was months away from her tragic maiden voyage. In New York, women marched for suffrage, and throughout America, the Model T was changing the entire concept of personal transportation. It was a time when pulp magazines like Argosy and All Story fed a growing appetite for fiction, which the publisher Frank A. Muncy declared was of the people and for the people. Science fiction, as it is known today, did not exist, but the pulps, true to Muncy's declaration, provided a steady diet of adventure, romance, and suspense to an eager readership. It was in February 1912 when All Story magazine published the first installment of what the editor would call an interplanetary romance, a tale of a Confederate war soldier named John Carter who was miraculously transported to Mars, where he fought to survive among creatures known as Tharks and warring races of men, eventually winning the love of the incomparable Deja Thoris, Princess of Helium. The imaginative tale, written by a struggling businessman named Edgar Rice Burroughs in Chicago, captured the imagination of the readers of All Story before going on to publication as a book in 1917 entitled A Princess of Mars, which in turn led to first a trilogy, then a series of 11 books published over the next 20 years. Edgar Rice Burroughs, who was paid $400 for the serial rights to the first book, would become the best-known author not just in the U.S., but worldwide. His books outsold his contemporaries, Fitzgerald, Faulkner, and Hemingway combined. His other creation, Tarzan of the Apes, became the best-known literary character in history. But it was John Carter and Burroughs' depiction of Mars that fired the creative energies of writers, filmmakers, and scientists alike. Listen to what legendary science fiction writer Ray Bradbury has to say about Burroughs. Burroughs is probably the most influential writer in the history of the world. I've talked to more biochemists and more astronomers who fell in love with John Carter and Tarzan and decided to become something romantic. Burroughs put us on the moon. All the technologists read Burroughs.